That's that.
Well, hello, everybody, and welcome to Vinyl Treasures. I'm your host, Johnny G, John Galindo, coming to you live each and every Saturday, only here on Top Shelf Oldies. Want to welcome you to the June 4th, right? It's June 4th, 2016, 50s and early 1960s edition of the Vinyl Treasures Show. Glad you can join Johnny G on this kind of muggy day here in New York City. Really wasn't as nice as it was the couple days before, but I know we had rain one day, but it was really nice earlier in the week. It was actually cool last night, but then the humidity came in, and I am up here in the attic broadcasting my 50s and early 60s show. And I have to tell you something that happened to me after I did the show last Saturday evening. I had to go to the emergency room, had to be rushed to the emergency room. I had a diverticulitis attack. It was horrible. It was horrible. I was in the emergency room from 4 a.m. till 11:30. It was terrible, and it's better. I'm getting better. I'm almost better, but I'm here playing my cool 45s, all original 45s, 1950s and early 60s. We open up the 50s edition of the Vinyl Treasure Show with a record that was number one. It was a number one record on KWBR in Oakland, California, November of 1958 for this organist, pianist from Philadelphia, PA. And you know who he is. You know his signature song was in 1956. If you remember a song called Honky Tonk Part 1 and Part 2, that was Mr. Bill Doggett. Bill Doggett there received a lot of regional airplay on that 45. It made it up to number 92, though, on the Billboard charts, number one out in California. November 58, Bill Doggett with a song called Hold It on Sid Nathan's King record label, as we always open up with an instrumental. Well, enough of my babbling here. Let's start it off with the vocal portion. It's been almost a year since I've featured this 45 out of New York City. I like it a lot. One I never knew about, though. One of my local dealers, he asked me if I needed this record. I said I did. It wasn't cheap, but it wasn't so expensive. But it's on one of George Goldner's label. This one is called Regal Records. Now, Goldner must have had some, his favorite colors must have been red with black lettering, because that's what this label is. It's red with black print, just like his G label and just like the TG label that he used to distribute. But this one is similar, and I have no info on the group, but they're known as Five Sharps and a Flat. It's from late 1958, Regal Records. Let's give it a spin. Five Sharps and a Flat with their tune called Wait For Me.
I love you with all my heart. Oh, yeah. I can't bear to let us part. Oh, yeah. I don't want a love that's new. Oh, yeah. I just want to be with you. Oh, yeah.
Oh, wait.
That's on a George Gollner label, Regal Records, for that one. 1958 release. No information on this group. I tried and tried, Charlene tried and tried, but we couldn't find anything on the group. Five Sharps and a Flat is the name of that one there. Song entitled Wait For Me. Cool up-tempo tune to start off the vocal portion of the Vinyl Treasure Show. Let's continue here. Got a EP up next. A budget EP, I guess we can call this one. It's on the Audio Lab label out of Cincinnati, Ohio. And it was a budget label that was owned by label owner Sid Nathan. Of course, he had three big labels at the time, King, Federal, and Deluxe. But he did put out a budget label, believe it or not. It was called Audio Lab. There were a lot of LPs that came out, and there were a few EPs, and this is a pretty cool EP. There was never a cover. It was only a paper sleeve that came with this one, and all four sides are excellent. These tracks, though, it sounds like a 1957 sound, all these tracks, but really they were recorded September 27th, 1959, and the record was released in March of 1960. That was according to Ferdy Gonzalez's Discophile. I'm playing side one, track one. The writer is John Dickerson. The group is called The Incredible Upsetters. I posted this one on my Facebook page as I did that. That's a Regal record too, by the way. But this was from March of 60. This is the first cut, The Incredible Upsetters on Audio Lab. Give a listen to their tune. It's called Baby, I'm Your Man. Audio Lab Records, they're out of Cincinnati, Ohio, for The Incredible Upsetters, March 1960 release there, although recorded almost a year earlier, 1959 there, The Incredible Upsetters with Baby, I'm Your Man. Actually, all the cuts on that EP are really good. I'll play a few more as we continue in the upcoming weeks here on the Vinyl Treasure Show on Top Shelf Oldies. Let's continue here for this next 45. Just came in the mail today. I was happy to get this 45 at a very, very reasonable price as we stay on the Sid Nathan parent label King Records for this vocalist, drummer, and pianist and band leader from Youngstown, Ohio. Had five top 10 10 hits on the Billboard R&B charts between May 1950 and August 1953. And this one was not a hit, but probably should have been an R&B hit for him. And I just got this one in on blue vinyl. I don't know if any of those looking in the Ustream broadcaster that I'm recording for the YouTube account saw this, but I took a photo of this 45 and put it on my Facebook page. If you look really closely, you will see it's not the black vinyl. It is like a light bluish or greenish, bluish green vinyl. Looks pretty cool if you shine a light through it. But anyway, I love this tune. Some of you may know this song is covered by the Johnny Burnett Trio on the Coral label in 1956, but this is the original from February 1952, Sid Nathan's King record label. It's Tiny Bradshaw. Tiny Bradshaw and the tune called The Train Kept a Rollin'.
Whoa, bop today.
Oh, what a girl.
Oh, bop today.
Oh, what a girl.
Boo-dow.
Boo-dow.
Boo-day.
Boo-day.
Bop today.
Oh, what a girl.
I hopped the train. I met a real dame. She was a hipster and a gone dame. She was pretty from New York City. And she trucked on down the old fair lane with a heave and ho. And I just couldn't let her go. So get along, sweet little woman, get along. Better be on your way, get along. Sweet little woman, get along. Better be on your way with a heave and a ho. And I just couldn't let her go. Yes, the train kept rolling
all night long.
Yeah, the train kept rolling
all night long. So fine, Jack, I couldn't let her go. Get along, sweet little woman, get along. Better be on your way, get along. Sweet little woman, get along. Better be on your way with a heave and a ho. And I sure couldn't let her go. Yeah, the train kept rolling all night long.
Oh, the train kept rolling
all night long.
Original versions here on the Vinyl Treasure Show is Johnny G Gets Caught. Yes, I do. I'm trying to answer some people asking me questions there in the Top Shelf Oldies chat. But that's a cool tune there by Tiny Bradshaw. That is the original version of the tune. He co-wrote the tune there from February 1952 on Sid Nathan's King record label, the song called The Train Kept A-Rollin'. As we keep a-rollin' here for a Saturday evening, 10 to midnight, 1950s and early 60s, all original vinyl out of my collection. Let's go stay with the King. What is this, the King record label show? I don't know, but I do have another one on King. I don't know if I have any more after this, but anyway, let's stay on Sid Nathan's King label. Let's flip over a 45 from the last 50s edition. By this group out of the Baltimore, Washington, D.C. area. I played the second of two they recorded for King, a song called Cool Cool Baby, which was the intended A-side of the 45, but those early rhythm and blues vocal group collectors, they love the B-side of the 45, as do I. As we go back to October 1953 for this group called the Magic Tones with Joe Reed on lead, King Records. Give a listen to their tune. It's called How Can You Treat Me This Way?
Way down deep inside are tears I cannot hide. I want you more and more each day. I miss that old thrill. I know I always will. How can you treat me this way? I'm blue and all alone. Can't melt your heart of stone. I love you more than words can say. Just can't conceal the heartaches that I feel. How can you treat me this way? You play the game of pretending from the very first time we met. I was thrilling to your kisses. You were planning goodbye with no regrets. So, way down deep inside are tears I cannot hide. I want you more and more each day. I miss that old thrill. I know I always will. How can you treat me this way?
I do love those ballads, Warren, just like you do. That is a great tune there by the Magic Tones. That's the B-side of the 45. Joe Reed on lead goes way back to October 1953, Sid Nathan's King record label. Now, that group, the Magic Tones, some of the members would... some of the members of this group will record on the Halfum label with Bobby Jackson doing lead. Those are the same, some of the members are the same Magic Tones that just recorded on the King label, but they don't make records like that anymore, folks. John G here spinning original vinyl 45s, hopefully not too scratchy. And here's another flip side from a couple of weeks ago on the Bahari Brothers Flair label, as I featured Ricky and Janelle. And in reality, Ricky was really Richard Berry, and Janelle was really Janelle Hawkins. The side that I played was called Each Step. That was the intended B-side, so let's give a spin to the intended A-side. From March of 1954, Ricky and Janelle on Flair, and this is the A-side of the 45, a song called This Time It's Real.
Oh, open up your arms and give me your heart.
March 1954 release there for Ricky and Janelle, Richard Berry and Janelle Hawkins on that one. That's the A side of the 45 on the Bahari Brothers Flair label out of Culver City, California. Song entitled This Time It's Real. You know it's real every Saturday right here on Top Shelf Oldies. I don't play any MP3s and I don't play any CDs, all original vinyl. Been trying to post some of my rare 45s on my Facebook wall. Have some more to go. I will try to put them in. Kind of went out for a couple hours. Me and Barbara did some walking around town. We did for a couple hours, had an amazing time. We did. And then came back, and Charlene and I, we were doing some of the research on these groups. And here's a group out of the Bronx, New York. Their debut single came out on Jerry Blaine's Josie label. Maybe some of you are familiar with a song called My Plea for Love in April of 1954. But then they signed to Sidney Siegel's Dawn label. And here's the first of two they recorded on the Dawn label. It features dual leads, Bill Lindsay and Larry Gales. They are doing lead. They're called the Starlings. The Starlings here, February 1955. The Starlings on Dawn with their tune called I'm Just a Crying Fool.
Wop, wop, do me, do me, wop, wop, do me, do me, wop, wop, do me, do me, wop. Wop, wop, do me, do me, wop, wop, do me, do me, wop, wop, do me, do me, wop.
My head is heavy,
my baby's gone.
I'm going crazy,
I can't go on, pretty baby.
My head is aching,
my hold is breaking.
Whoa, baby, I'm just a crying fool.
Woke up this morning,
tears filled my bed.
My heart was hurting,
wish I were dead, pretty mama.
I can't believe
my baby's leaving.
Whoa, baby, I'm just a crying fool. Baby took my love and baby took my time.
Now I'm so sad and blue.
Now I'm all alone. Won't you please come home?
I can't go on without you.
Oh, 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 oh.
You said you love me
all through the years.
I can't believe that
you leave me in tears. Oh, baby,
can't stop from crying.
I feel like dying.
Whoa, baby, I'm just a crying. Wop, wop, do me, do me, wop, wop, do me, do me, wop, wop, do me, do me, wop.
Took my love and took my time.
Now I'm so sad and blue.
Wop, wop, wop. Now I'm all alone. Won't you please come home? I can't go on without you.
Oh, 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 oh. You said you loved me
all through the years.
I can't believe that
you leave me in tears, pretty baby.
Can't stop from crying.
I feel like dying.
Whoa, baby, I'm just a crying.
Womp, womp, do me, do me, womp,
womp. I'm just a crying.
Womp, do me, do me, womp,
womp. I should have gone to school.
February 1955, release here for a group called the Starlings. This was the time, 1955, where everybody was being called or named after a bird. Named after a bird. The Orioles, the Starlings, the Blue Jays. You can go on and on. I think there was sparrows. I think every bird name except maybe some of those really exotic birds. I guess there's no group under those names, but those are the Starlings there on the Dawn record label. I'm Just a Crying Fool. Now, this group, they would later on have two more releases on the MGM record label, two great releases, as the Twilighters, if you're familiar with the tune Little Did I Dream and Half Angel, but that's the group, the Starlings. Let's continue here for a Saturday evening. Up next, I have one of my favorites by this Chicago, Illinois group, as I played the A-side of their fifth release on Vivian Carter's VJ record label, a song called Rock and Rolls for Me. And it's just, really, I needed an up-tempo side, and that was decent enough to play here on the Vinyl Treasure Show, but I really wanted to play the B-side of the 45, which was released in March of 1956, but it was recorded June 8th of 1955. It's with Al Smith and his orchestra. It features Percolee Moses on lead. This one released in March of 56, recorded in 55. Of course, I'm talking about the Eldorados. The Eldorados on VJ. Give a listen to their tune. It's called Now That You've Gone.
You've gone. Now that I love you so, oh darling, why did you go? Oh darling, now that you've gone, yes, you've gone, yes, you're gone. Now that my heart beats for you, why do you want somebody new? Darling, now that you've gone, yes, gone, yes, when I want you near, but since is come back here, you've gone. Now that I need you so, why did you ever go? Darling, now that you've gone, yes, now that you've gone, now that you've gone, now that you've gone. Besides
here on the Vinyl Treasure Show, those are the Eldorados, Percolee Moses on lead for that one. March 1956 release, although they recorded it in 1955, June 8th of 1955, Vivian Carter's VJ record label, one of the thousands of labels that your host Johnny G collects the Eldorados with, Now That You've Gone. Johnny G not going, not till at least midnight here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. We do Vinyl Treasure Overtime. It's all original vinyl. Let's continue here. But it's a request. I got a request up for Bopper Boy Warren. Sent Johnny G an email at vinyltreasures@aol.com. You can also get me at Johnny G. JohnnyGVinyltreasures@gmail.com. Did I say that right, Charlene? I don't remember. You can contact my administrative assistant in the chat room there, Charlene. She will give you that information for sure. But I don't know much about this group, Warren, but it's a great two-sided 45, and they have this lone release on Henry Stone's Chart record label out of Miami, Florida, and Warren requested the B-side of the 45, which has a great, excellent, killer guitar break for sure. And I guess it, hence the name of the tune, name of the song. It's called Guitar Player. This one from August 1955 by request for Bopper Boy Warren. These are the Evergreens on Chart with their tune called Guitar Player.
Well, guitar player,
baby, she's so fine, but now she's gone.
About to lose my mind, guitar player. Play the blues for me. Well, she left at 9 this morning, and here it is, all over me.
Got eyes like a baby, ways like a doll. I can't forget her.
She's my all in all guitar player. Play those blues for me. She left at 9 this morning, and here it is almost 3.
By request there for Bopper Boy Warren, currently in our top shelf oldies jam. He wanted to hear the Evergreens from August 1955 on the Chart record label, Henry Stone's Chart label. You know, Henry Stone also owned the TK label with KC and the Sunshine Band. So if you ask any of your disco friends about that, of Henry Stone, they sure know. He was actually a Facebook friend for a while until he passed away. But that's a cool request, Warren. A B-side there by the Evergreens, Guitar Player. Johnny here spinning original vinyl 45s. Let's continue here and continue with the B-sides. This time, a B-side of a classic song I played by this group from Los Angeles, California. Now, the A-side that's so many of you did enjoy, and a lot of people like this record, The Way You Look Tonight, came out on Bob Ross's Ardell record label. Now, that was a constant seller for the group as an oldie through the years. A lot of the oldie stations I could listen to, WABC during the 1960s, they would play that record, and it continued to sell through the years, and Ardell continued to put the record out, but not with the original B-side of the record. It had a different side. I forget the name of it. It was called Baby, 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 I think. But so we're going to flip this 45 over and give a listen to the original B-side of the 45, as the side was written by the lead singer, Val Poliuto. I think that's how you pronounce it, if I said it right. And I have this one on red vinyl. Looks pretty cool on that yellow Ardell label and the red print Ardell. But anyway, it's a B-side. We flip over. The Way You Look Tonight came out originally October 1956. The Jaguars on Ardell with a B-side. Song called Moonlight and You.
Moonlight. that moonlight shining in the sky up above will shine down on us, and I love I do. Please answer by saying I love you too by moonlight. And you will make all my dreams come true.
Besides here on the Vinyl Treasure Show, there really are, I mean, usually when I was working for Sony Music and my boss, my manager, Brian Kelleher, he would tell me that during the late 60s and early 70s, a lot of the B-sides were like throwaway sides. And then later on, when they were putting out the promotional copies, they would have the same song on both sides. Like they would have the extended version on one side, and they would have the radio version on the other side. Well, some of those records do go for a lot more money on the big hits, by the way, though. Really, they do. But anyway, they were with a lot of the 50s records, the B-sides were just as good as the A-sides. And that is the B-side to The Way You Look Tonight by the Jaguars. It's called Moonlight and You, October 1956 on the Ardell record label. John G here spinning original vinyl 45s out of my collection. Let's continue. Here we go to Detroit, Michigan for this next group. Group on Devorah Brown's Fortune record label. Now, this specific, well, not only this specific 45, but a lot of this group's 45s, they were released with the different color labels, I guess, depending on how well it sold. But for this record that I'm playing, came out on multiple variations. I think on the purple label, which is the true original. You could also get it on the maroon. I have like a VG copy on maroon. I have a better copy on the blue label. And I think I also have a white DJ of this record. Now, the thing to know about this 45 is there is one that is with an extended ending, with a longer ending, and I don't know if this is the one, although it looks like there's not a lot of dead wax at the end of the record, so this might be the extended version of the song, but we will see after it gets toward the end. But anyway, a lot of people do love this group from Detroit. And, of course, this is their sixth of 19 that they recorded on Devorah Brown's Fortune record label. I think this is the first release where the lead singer gets credit, because usually it was featuring him and featuring Nolan Strong. But now, by this time, they were known as Nolan Strong and the Diablos. Let's go back to April 1956. He also wrote the tune. It's Nolan Strong and the Diablos on Fortune with their tune called You Are.
You are like the sunshine in the morning, like the moonlight in the evening.
That is definitely the extended version of the 45 of the song. Definitely it is. Nolan Strong and the Diablos there, their sixth release on Devorah Brown's Fortune record label. I had it, just featured it on the Purple Label Silver Writing, April 1956, song entitled You Are. Let's continue here for a Saturday evening. Hope you're digging on these tunes. Got some more B-sides of records I played a couple weeks ago on my 50s edition. I featured the A-side of this 45 on Herman Lubinsky's Savoy record label by a group called the Savoys. The A-side was a song called Say Your Mind, featured Jimmy Jones on lead. And previous to this group, the Savoys, he was a member of the Sparks of Rhythm on Apollo. So let's flip this 45 over and give a spin to the B-side of the 45s. April 1956, the Savoys, featuring Jimmy Jones on lead on Savoy out of Newark, New Jersey, with a B-side. One Word, a song entitled You.
You're a heart for me. You're with always be. Mind on mind all the time. All the time. You set my soul on fire. You are my desire. Cause I love you, darling, I do. Yes, I do. You were meant for me, darling, I know. Yes, it is plain to see that I should not never let you go, 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 go,
besides here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. Those are the Savoys. Jimmy Jones, unmistakable voice of Jimmy Jones on lead there, April 1956 release on the Savoy label, song entitled You. I think later on in 1960, when he was having hits with Handyman and Good Time, and they re-released that record, not that side though, I don't know if You was on the flip side of the, I know the other side came out again later on Savoy around 1960. Anyway, trying to capitalize, all these record owners, they tried to capitalize on a lot of things that were going on, and maybe the least amount of effort, I don't know, maybe though, to press up the records and not to have a hit, I don't know, but maybe they needed some tax write-offs, I don't know. John G here babbling on for a Saturday evening, hope you're digging on the tunes. We play 50s in the first hour, 60s in the second. Let's continue here. We are in a string of 1956 releases, and I have to say, lots of the flip sides of a couple weeks ago, I am playing this week, either A or B sides, and they are good sides. I do. I hopefully you agree with your host, Johnny G. But here is another B side here. No, actually, it is the A side of the 45, as I featured the B side for this Harlem, New York group. I played the fifth of seven on George Golner's Rama record label. The song was called I'll Never Let You Go. Now, the A-side is a ballad, and it was their follow-up to somewhat of a New York hit that they had on Rama, if you're familiar with the song called The Woo-Woo Train. And, of course, I'm talking about the Valentines, and this was written by the lead singer. His name is Richard Barrett. It's with Jimmy Wright and the orchestra. This is the A-side. It's a ballad from June of 56, the Valentines on Rama, with their tune called 20 Minutes, parentheses, before the hour.
Until the hour, dear, 20 more minutes I can stay right here. But at 12 o'clock, I must go home.
I must go home. Oh.
20 more minutes I can. Until the hour, dear, but at 12 o'clock, I must go home. I love to stay here all night, kiss you, dearest, in the silvery light, hold you close to me and squeeze you real tight. But soon I'll have to go. The hour isn't far. 20 more minutes I can linger, dear. 20 more minutes I can hold you near. But at 12 o'clock, I must go home. But at 12 o'clock, 12 o'clock, I must go home.
12 o'clock, 12 o'clock, 12 o'clock, baby. 12 o'clock, 12 o'clock.
I remember when I first heard that song, it was on the Gus Gossard Show. He used to play that song. I think in the last hour he used to play a lot of ballads, and he would play that tune. I love the Valentines. Of course, you know I hold the Valentines close to my heart because their I Love You Darling was really the record that got me collecting all these rhythm and blues vocal groups. But those are the Valentines. Richard Barrett on lead, June 1956 release on the Rama label. Song entitled 20 Minutes Before the Hour. No, it is not. At 12 o'clock, John G will be doing some Vinyl Treasure Overtime. Let's continue here for another flip side from last week's show. This time, one of the rarer releases to ever come out of Central New York on the Vesta label, Vesta Records out of Syracuse, New York. I played the A-side of the 45 by a group called the Rhythm Cadets. Dearest Doris was the name of the tune. It featured Bebo Singleton on lead for that one. Now, the B-side was written by group member Otis Smith, and he is doing lead. This one features Jim McCann on guitar, so he's probably doing a cool guitar break on this one. So we go back to November of 1957 on the Vesta label. These are the Rhythm Cadets. The Rhythm Cadets, and I didn't write the song. But it's called Rockin' Jimmy.
Well, we know a cat, they call him Rockin' Jimmy. Well, now we know a cat, they call him Rockin' Jimmy. Well, he plays his best when lights are dim. Well, now when Jimmy plays, he plays right on the beat. Well, when Jimmy plays, well, he plays so hot, he'll knock you off your feet. Well, come on and rock, well, Jimmy rock, yeah, Jimmy rock, oh, Jimmy rock, hey, Jimmy, let's rock.
Yes, Warren, Pops and Clicks. At least it's on that side. It's not on the ballad side for a very rare record there. Although you listen to Mark over in the UK, he says the Pops and Clicks make it extra special. Right, Mark? You tell him. Anyway, those are the Rhythm Cadets with a B-side there. Rhythm Cadets, November 1957 on the Vesta label. Rockin' Jimmy, cool rockin' guitar on that one. Let's continue here. John G's spinning my original vinyl. You're going to get pops like that. I can't get every record in mint Like Hi-Fi Tim has all his MP3s in mint, but sometimes you just can't get the 45s in mint when you're a collector like Johnny G. And I played, here is one more B-side from a couple weeks ago as we go to Brooklyn, New York for this group known as the Crescents, spelled kind of odd, C-R-E-S-E-N-T-S, the Crescents. And the side that I played was the A-side, a song called Everybody Knew But Me. But this one is on the Al Brown Associated Joyce record label. Let's give a listen to the B-side, which is also a ballad, kind of unusual for a group to have ballads on both sides, although it has happened. Yes, it has. Sometimes they also have up-tempos on both sides. Usually it's an up-tempo and a ballad, but these are ballads on both sides for this Crescents group. Really don't know much about them, though. This one released in December of 56. We go to Joyce Records, the Crescents with You Have No Heart.
You have no
sides here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. I love the hint of echo in these records. Forget about any of the music of today. Nobody wants to hear echo, but for these nice ballads of the 1950s, it just had a great sound to them. Of course, not a lot of instrumentation, a lot of the vocal styles that we hear in this music, which is why we like it. December 56 release there on the Joyce record label out of Brooklyn, New York for the Crescents. The Crescents with a song entitled You Have No Heart. But John G has a heart every Saturday right here on Top Shelf Oldies. From 10 to midnight, I spin my original vinyl 45s. We do it three Saturdays of the month. We do 1950s and early 60s. And the last Saturday, it's all 1960s show, 64 and later. That was last week. Let's continue here. We continue. And actually, this is an ultra-rare 45. Actually, Warren, in his email, he asked if I would play this record. Now, this record was booted. I mean, I don't even know how common the boot is, but it definitely looks different than the original. And this is, for you collectors out there, if you have this on original, it's a really thick press, really heavy press for this record. And I just got it in the mail, I think on Tuesday or Wednesday. And I've never seen an original copy of this for sale. So I bid a lot of money on it. And the guy described it as VG Plus, but of course it is better than that. So I was pleasantly surprised. So Warren wanted me to give it a whirl. We're going to do it here. And I'm featuring the A side of the 45. It's a ballad. The label, I guess I'm going to say, the label is out of New York City, out of 1674 Broadway. It was owned by Ulysses Smith and Tony Acquaviva. I posted this one on my Facebook wall. You can see the label. It's called Dynamic Records. Now, it's the same label that the Unique Teens recorded for, except it's earlier. This release is like 1956. And then the label was resurrected again, I think in 59, when the Unique Teens recorded What You Know New. You might have that 45 on the Dynamic label. But anyway, let's go back to 1956 for a group called the Voltones, V-O-L-T-O-N-E-S, the Voltones on Dynamic. And the name of the tune is called If She Should Call. They would say from the Time Capsule show, from the Collector's Corner. There, that's what they would say. That's a rare 45 by the Voltones, 1956 release on the Dynamic label. Song entitled If She Should Call. Now, somebody had this record as 1964. Like, no way, Jose. No way. But anyway, that's a rare 45. There you go, Warren. That is the tune there. Let's continue here for a Saturday evening. I'm spinning my 1950s and early 60s vocal group records here. We do it every Saturday right here on Top Shelf Oldies from 10 to midnight. Got a rare girl group sound up next as we head to the Bronx, New York. I posted this one also. These next these next three records. We heard record number one. This is record number two. You can go see what record number three will be on my Facebook wall. But anyway, this group is from the Bronx, New York, on Zell Sanders' JNS record label, this time out of 1651 Washington Avenue in the Bronx, New York. And I have the B-side up to play. It features Justine Baby Washington on lead. And I think this is their first record on the JNS record label, at least for this group called The Hearts. And listen closely, because you're going to hear Baby Washington shout out, "Blow, Sam, blow." And that is for Sam the Man Taylor playing saxophone on this record. Anyway, it's from February 57. These are The Hearts on JNS. Give a listen to their tune. It's called "You Needn't Tell Me, I Know."
You needn't tell me I know it's on your mind. You're in love with the girl most time. Don't tell me I know it's on your mind. And my baby, don't you put me down. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. When you need me, I'm all around. Everybody says I'm your crown. When you need me, I'm all around. Now, baby, I've been treating you fine.
Rare girl group sounds here for a Saturday evening. Those are The Hearts. Baby Washington on lead. Zell Sanders, JNS record label for that one. The Hearts with the B-side, "You Needn't Tell Me, I Know." Flip side's a nice ballad, "Dancing in a Dream World." I'll get that one on a future Vinyl Treasure show. Let's continue with the next Rare 45. As we go to turntable number two here on Bobby Robinson's Fury record label. Now, the leader of this group was half of a duo that recorded for the Red Robin record label, if you're familiar with Charles and Carl. And he was also a member of the Valentines on the Rama record label. And then he was the lead singer of this group, which included Leon Briggs, Joe Brisbane, Irving Lee Gale, and Jerry Moore. And of course, the lead singer, that being Carl Hogan. They were known as Carl Hogan and the Miracles. This is a Rare 45 on Bobby Robinson's Fury record label from 1957. It's Carl Hogan and the Miracles with a song called "Your Love" (parentheses) is all I need.
Your
You're the love for me.
So what'd you think of that 45, folks? Isn't that a great tune there by Carl Hogan? Carl Hogan and the Miracles, that one there on the Fury record label. Early Fury number 1003. 1957 release, Carl Hogan and the Miracles, with a song entitled Your Love, parentheses, is all I need. Well, your listening pleasure is all that Johnny G needs every Saturday from 10 to midnight right here on Top Shelf Oldies. Let's continue for this next group. I love this group out of Englewood, New Jersey. Recorded 7 on B. Castlin's Hull record label. This is their 3rd of 7. Features Bob Lee on lead. This one from December of 1957. Of course, I'm talking about the Avons. The Avons on Hull with their tune called Gonna Catch You Napping. That's the 3rd release there for the Avons on B. Castlin's Hull record label. December 1957, Bob Lee on lead there. Song entitled Gonna Catch You Napping. Flip side's a great ballad. You Are So Close to Me. I love that sound too. Yes, I do. I had to get another copy of this record. I paid a lot more for it because I have, as Dave the Rave yells at me, because I have all these records along the edge. When you come up in the attic, there are dormers here up in the attic, and there's this big stairwell, and there is, my father made this like shelving that goes around the top of the stairwell. It's like a solid, like kind of like semi-wall there, and I have the records piled on top, and I don't know what happened. Somebody either came up here and maybe there was a worker that checked the thermostat, and I had a mint copy that was And I had to get another mint copy, of course. That was a clean copy. But it was broken in half. I have it in my office in Newark. I stuck it right on. You know, you can stick those pin cushion wall things where you put paper on there. I broke all the vinyl off of it, and I have the label just sticking up there on my wall. Anyway, I was really upset with that. Now, a couple times I have dropped a few records, as some of you know, and I have cracked them. I was really upset. Yes, I do. Well, enough of my babbling here. Let's continue for this next group. They are from Kingston, Jamaica, and they did spend some time here in the Bronx, New York, and they have some releases, some U.S. releases on the Asnes label and also the Crystal label. I don't know if though if it might have been recorded in here in the Bronx or in and then pressed in Jamaica. I don't know about that label, but I do have their releases on the Bluebeat label, which is a UK label. I think they have three on Bluebeat, which are very good records, and so is this one that I'm featuring, which is also on a UK press. So Mark, you might be able to find this group over there across the pond if you look. So I know they have records on Bluebeat, and also have records on this label called Starlight. And a lot of those UK presses had the center, had like the center hole piece, similar to what a lot of the early, you can get a lot of the early Capitol records with the center hole piece in. Some people used to punch them out. I like them with them in. It just looks different. It's just different. A lot of those pop records when I used to collect Capitol records. But this has the center hole piece. Now, the label's called Starlight. And now, listen closely to the song because it sounds like another song to me. It's like they stole this from someone. Maybe something that Johnny and Joe sang. I don't know, but I just can't place the song. Maybe you can place the song, but it features Derek Harriott on lead, and he gets writer credit for this one here. And it sounds like a 50s record, but supposedly it was released in December of 1960. But you listen to it, you let me know what you think. These are the Jivin' Juniors, the Jivin' Juniors on Starlight from England. This press is from England, and the name of the tune is called To Woo Up To Woo.
Goodbye.
I think the song is called I Was So Lonely. I just can't place who did the record. Was it someone on Taurus? I don't know who, but anyway, I know that song. And evidently they kind of like rearranged it a little bit, made it a little bit slower. But those are the Jivin Juniors. The Jivin Juniors December 1960 release on the Starlight label. They are out of the UK. I just posted this one on my Facebook wall. You can check out the label. Tu-woo-oop-tu-woo is the name of the tune. Yes, Warren, I have Moonlight Lover on the Asnes label. I think that was from 1961. I do have that 45. Anyway, Jaji here spinning only original vinyl 45s. We do it every Saturday right here on Top Shelf Oldies. Let's continue. We are in 1958. I like this next record for this group from the Fort Greene section of Brooklyn, New York, and one of the many vocal groups that had like one or two records and just faded into obscurity, although there was one member of this group that did go on that maybe you do know. But this is their only release on Don Carter's Pet label, and the lead singer, he goes by the name of Nathaniel Butch Epps, and you will also hear the bass of the group. The bass of the group, his name is Curtis Fulch, and in the early 1960s, he would record under a different name, Kurt Harris. And maybe you know some of his releases on the Josie label. Does an expensive northern tune on the Diamond label called Emperor of My Baby's Heart. But he's doing bass on this. Lead singer here, Nathaniel Butch Epps. This one from November of 58. Give a listen to the Capitals. The Capitals on Pet with their tune called 'Cause I Love You.
Boom, 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 shoo-dee-doo-dee-doo-wop, shoo-dee-doo-wop, shoo-dee-doo-dee-doo-wop, 'cause I love you, shoo-dee-doo-dee-doo-wop, shoo-dee-doo-wop, shoo-dee-doo-dee-doo-wop, 'cause I love you so.
November 1958 release here for the Capitals. The Capitals on the Pet record label. Cool tune there, song entitled Cause I Love You. The flip side's actually a good tune also. We'll get that one on a future Vinyl Treasure Show. Johnny here spinning 1950s and early 60s vocal groove harmony out of my collection, all on original vinyl. Let's continue here. We go into 1959. We go back out to California for this group from the Pasadena area. Not much really known about the group, though, but it's their lone release on Dootsie Williams' Duto record label. And I can tell you who the writer is. I don't know who. Eddie Martin is his name. But anyway, let's give it a spin. We move into 59, February 59 to be exact, for Eli Price and the Manhattans on the Duto label. A song called My Big Dream.
To place my golden bed.
My Desire. That's what that record sounds like. That's a cool tune there, Warren. I agree. That's a cool one there by Eli Price and the Manhattans, Dootsie Williams Duto record label. That's their only release, February 1959. My Big Dream. Johnny G here spinning original vinyl 45s out of my collection. We are on the Ustream broadcaster showing those collectors my live broadcast, live 45s. They can see them on the turntable. We'll post it up on YouTube. Didn't have that much of a problem with the copyright police on my last show. At least they did give me some grief, but they let everything play, thank goodness. But I don't know about this show. But let's continue here. Let's stay out in California. We go to Jake Porter's combo label, as this lead singer was also the lead singer of the Sharps, but he took a temporary leave of absence to record this song for Jake Porter. Now, the group in the background are just studio backup singers, but the group is called The Buddies. Actually, it's Carl L. and The Buddies. Now, Carl L. is really Carl White. Carl White, member of the Rivingtons and the Sharps and a bunch of other groups for sure. But I like this record here from January 1959. Let's give it a spin. Carl L. and The Buddies on combo, and their tune called Bobby, My Love.
Bobby, my love. Bobby, Bobby, help me, you are my girl.
That's Carl L. and the Buddies, really good. Carl White on lead for that one. January 1959, Jake Porter's combo record label, Bobby My Love, they spell the name. I don't know if girls are spelled with a Y, but that's how they spell it. It should be B-O-B-B-I. Now, Mary Kinney, she also, she covered this song, Bobby My Love, the female singing to the male, and that is Bobby My Love on the Andex label, which is also the Keen label, by the way, if any of you didn't know that. Andex, and Andex and Keen, they use the same numbering system. That's on the combo label. That's a cool tune. John G here spinning original vinyl 45. Let's continue. Let's stay out in California. This time in Los Angeles to Eddie and Leo Mesra's Aladdin label. And I have no info on this group, but it's a great two-sided 45. I pulled out a couple boxes because I got some Amy records coming up, and I got another record on Ace. I pulled out a couple on Ace, but I only picked one of them. And some on Aladdin, and this is the one that I chose on Aladdin. Actually, both sides are good, but we're going to give a listen to the up-tempo side by this group called the Royal Halos, and it's their lone single. This one from September of 59, the last record out of 59, the Royal Halos on Aladdin, with a song called Nobody But Me and My Girl.
Nobody but me and my girl, picked up by 7:15. The finest thing you ever seen. We started riding, just riding around, and then we thought about going downtown. We went up. Nobody now, nobody now. Nobody but me and my girl. We left town about 7:45. She says, you know, I can't stay. And at the beach it get real, real cold. That's when she started coming real close. We went out. Nobody now. Nobody, nobody now. Nobody but me and my girl. Nobody but me and my girl. I kissed her once, then I kissed her again. I said, come on, baby, do it again. I took her home, it was sad to part. That last kiss almost broke my heart. When nobody now, well, nobody, nobody now. Nobody but me and my girl.
Warren likes that record. You're going to like that record if you don't have it, Warren. If you can find, I don't know what it goes for now. Maybe about $100 or so. I don't know. I don't really see that one enough, or don't see it around much, if at all. That's on the Aladdin label, Eddie and Leo Mesra's Aladdin label. It is a styrene. I hate styrene. You guys know that, a styrene promo there. They're called the Royal Halos. Royal Halos from September 1959, Aladdin Records. Nobody But Me and My Girl was Nobody But Me and You, the Top Shelf Oldies listeners, every Saturday night from 10 to midnight. Let's continue here for another cover song, although this one was originally recorded by a group called the Rhythm Ears. Rhythm Hears or Rhythm Ears, H-E-I-R-S. It's two words. That group was out of El Paso, Texas. Came out in 1959 on the Yucca label, but then it was covered by this group, which I think is really a duet, and talking to my collector peers, they told me that they thought that this group was a duet, but it goes for a lot of money. Don't ask me why it goes for a lot of money, but it does. But I did not pay a lot for this. Only paid, I think, $50, only because it has the start of a hairline crack, although it doesn't have the crack. It's like, it looks like a crack is starting, but it didn't get to the outside of the edge. So that's how I'll describe it. But let's give this one a spin. It's from August of 1960. It's out of Texas. This is out of Shelbyville, Texas. It's called the DBC label. They're called the Uniques. It's a cover, a song called Cradle Rock. Rare 45 out of Texas, Shelbyville, Texas. I think that's where it's from. August 1960 release. They're called the Uniques. The Uniques on the DBC record label, song entitled Cradle Rock. Now, there is another somebody else also covered it again on the Donna label in 1963. A group called the Heartbreakers. They covered that 45 on Bob Keane's Donna record label. Johnny G here spinning original vinyl 45s. We are in the early 1960s now. Can't find any info on this next group, except I have two 45s by the group. One in 1959 on the renowned record label, and this one on the Emery label. Now, that renowned label is out of North Carolina, and this one is called Emery, and I'm guessing that it's out of North Carolina because there is a place called Emery, North Carolina. And the writers are Fuller and Allen, and Fuller appears to be the lead singer. His name is Irving Fuller. So let's give it a spin. July 1960, Irving Fuller and the Corvettes on Emery, E-M-E-R-Y. The song is called I Can't Stop.
I used to welcome girls spot since I started dating you. Baby, I can't stop. Kiss, 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 and it's a social game. Easy to play a drum. Since I started kissing you, baby, I can't stop. Can't stop kissing you, can't stop squeezing you, can't stop living so fine. I'm confessing my heart is yours, confess that yours is mine. I used to candle sweet romance, merely to let it fly. But since I've started loving you, baby, I can't stop.
July 1960 release on the Emery label. Irving Fuller and the Corvettes is the name of the group. The name of the tune is called I Can't Stop. John G can't stop playing these original vinyl 45s, so let's continue here as we head to Memphis, Tennessee. Isn't George in Tennessee? Yes, I think he is, but we're going to Memphis, Tennessee for this next 45. I have no clue who this artist is. It's a single artist with group backing. The writer goes by the name of Cecil McCracken, and its publisher is Hut Music, and the label is called Pepper Records. This one is from January 1960. Both sides are good on this 45. Let's give it a spin. It's by Johnny Rebel. Johnny Rebel on Pepper. The song is called Write Me a Letter.
Write me a letter, tell me I'm your fella. Why haven't you written in a long, long time? I've been here waiting, crying, anticipating, waiting to hear from you. The stars up in the sky, they know my reasons why. They know my heartaches and my misery. I love you dearly, I wish you were near me to take you in my arms. I miss you so each day. Had one wish, my wish would be just this, that our love may last, though years they may pass, and I'll remain, yes I will remain, oh I'll remain affectionately.
Yes, Warren, I have to agree with you. That is a great ballad and great vocal group backing them up there. His name is, as I lost my place, his name is Johnny Rebel. Johnny Rebel, January 1960 release on the Pepper label. Song entitled Write Me a Letter. Why don't you write Johnny G a letter? Send me an email at vinyltreasures@aol.com. Tell me that you're digging on the tunes and what you like best about tonight's show. I hope you dug on a lot of these, and maybe a lot of them you haven't heard before. Some of them I'm sure you have, but maybe others you did not. Like, I thought I had most of the Lori 45s, but you know, sometimes when I'm looking through eBay, I scroll through and I see something, I'm like, not sure. Usually I'm pretty sure, but not always with 185,000 45s, but this one didn't look familiar. So I checked in my Ken Klee book if I needed Lori number 3108, and I did. So I threw in a bid and I won the 45. Actually, I had to win it. It was actually a pretty cool tune. And it's by an artist that goes by the name of Byron Gibson. Now, he's in this release on Lori is from 1961. Now, Byron goes back to 1956 on the specialty label. He was known as Wild Child Gibson, and he had one that had some cool tunes on the specialty label that I do own, but this is an unusual one that he's here, has this one on the Lori label, and it really rocks and is, I guess we can call it a parody of a Little Richard song. If you know, I'm sure you know the song Long Tall Sally, because it mentions Uncle John in that song by Little Richard. Well, that's what the name of this tune is. It's called Uncle John. It's from August of 61. It's on Lori Records. This is the Special Release Press, which is their DJ press. So let's give it a spin. Byron Gibson on Lori with his tune called Uncle John.
Well, then Mary finally caught up with Uncle John. She caught him slipping sideways from the solid line. She got the rock, yeah. And a reeling and a rolling. Uncle John got a double dealing. Yeah. When she took Uncle John down the knuckle kitchen, she sounded like Grant when he shook up a Richmond old baby. She said them greenback quarters, nickel and dime, whatever that penny but back, oh baby. She got the reeling and a rolling. Uncle John got a double dealing. Oh yeah! John down the knuckle kitchen, she sounded like Grant when he shook up a Richmond old baby. She got the reeling and a rolling. Uncle John got a double dealing. Yeah. Uncle John got loose and Mary snatched him back. She said them green back quarters, nickel and dime, whatever that penny was back, oh baby. She got the reeling. John, is that you, honey? Come on in, dear.
Byron Gibson's his name. That one there from August 1961 on the Lori record label. Song entitled Uncle John. John G is spinning 45s out of my collection. We are in the 1960s. Let's go back one year to 1960. I was going through a vein of Amy 45s, pulled out a few for tonight's show, and here is one I have no clue about. The only thing I can say is that I purchased it from Ken Benedict, a dealer down in Florida, and he was at the Allentown All 45 and 78 shows, one of the ones that I attended, and I saw this 45. I didn't have it, and it is a duet with a vocal group backing them up on the Amy label. This is Amy number 808. those crappy painted on labels that I hate. And this is a, it's not an advanced copy, this is a stock copy, a purple Amy, and cheaply manufactured, of course, but I think it's Stone Mint. Let's give it a spin, from October of 1960. A duet that goes by the name of Henry and Mamie. Henry and Mamie, it's on Amy, and this is what Johnny G has. The name of the tune is called Two Big Feet.
Henry, come on, wake up from that dance with me.
Mamie, I don't want to dance.
Why?
You got big feet.
Who's got big feet?
You got two big feet.
I got two big feet.
You got two left clumsy feet, and they're too big, too big. When you go a dancing at the hop, you think you are rocking and rolling, but when you should be doing the slop, you look more like you were bowling. You got big feet.
Who's got big feet?
You got two big feet.
Oh, Henry, you must be kidding.
You got two left clumsy feet, and they're too big, too big. You're slipping and sliding all over the place, or dragging those gunboats around. If you don't watch out, you will fall on your face the minute you leave the ground. You got big feet.
Who's got big feet?
You got two big feet.
I got two big feet.
You got two left clumsy feet, and they're too big, too big.
Listen to that music, Henry. Come on, let's do the math.
The Madison, with them feet, it'll be more like the Frisco earthquake.
Well, let's do the slop then.
Not the slop, with them 15 triple A's, the Queen Mary for a partner. You got a figure that's long and slim, and your face, it looks so nice. But from your ankles on down, there's something wrong. You got big, big feet twice. You got big feet.
Who's got big feet?
You got two big feet.
Henry, you don't really mean that, do you?
You got two left clumsy feet, and they're too big. You got two left clumsy feet, and they are too big, too big. Mamie, what do you call a psychiatrist?
Henry, that's a head shrinker.
Well, what do you call a foot shrinker? Cause that's what you need.
Oh, Henry.
October 1960 release there for Henry and Mamie. Henry and Mamie on the Amy label. I say that one five times real fast. But anyway, that is Two Big Feet. I have to say, I am very large. I have a size 14. It's very difficult. Barbara and I went to Globe Shoes. Where are they? In Paramus, New Jersey, I think. I forget what they're called, but the guy brings it. I said, look, I want to try out a couple pairs of shoes. So he brings out this. I want one that's suede, and I want one that's leather, and I needed another one of those Merrells. But anyway, he said, well, these are the hot item, these hot things. So I put them on, and I said, boy, these really feel nice. He goes, well, the price is expensive too. They were $209. So I bought two pairs. I bought a pair of brown sweat. I have to find out the name of them, but they're like the hottest thing. They said we can't get enough in the store. And I bought a pair of Merrells. They were cheap. They were like $70, but the other two were $209 each. So very, very expensive. But you know, I have big feet. You want to feel nice and snug and comfortable with those big feet. But anyway, that is enough of my babbling here. Let's continue here on the Vinyl Treasure Show for this group from Brooklyn, New York. Initially, they recorded as the Impacts in 1959 on the Watts label. Very good 45 if you don't have them, but it cost a little bit for you collectors out there. But then they signed with RCA, and they changed their name to the Blue Chips. They had two releases on the RCA label. This is their first, produced by Hugo and Luigi. It features Kenneth Seymour on lead. Let's go back to August of 61. The Blue Chips on RCA, and their tune called Puddles of Tears.
La 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 la.
August 61 release there for the Blue Chips. The Blue Chips on the RCA record label, their tune called Puddles of Tears. Now, Kenneth Seymour, he was on lead. They would go on to have one more release on the DCP International label in 1965. If you have the 45, Kenny and the Impacts, that is the same group. Of course, we are crying Puddles of Tears that Muhammad Ali passed away. I couldn't believe it last night. I was pulling records out for the show and communicating with Charlene on Gmail, and I saw that he passed away. And then Barbara said, well, he did a record, didn't he? I couldn't find the record. I have it on Columbia. I do have that record. It's actually a pretty good record. I like the record. I do. But it's unfortunate that he passed away. All these people passing away. Oh, my goodness. Anyway, John G here for a Saturday evening spinning my original vinyl 45s. How appropriate. This next song is called The Ring, but it is not about the boxing ring. Actually, this is a request for Bopper Boy. Warren wanted to hear this group from Indianapolis, Indiana. Group consisted of Jimmy Guilford, Kenneth Moore, Jimmy Scruggs, and William Worm Harris, who is Thurston Harris's brother. And this is by request for Warren, a nice sound by a group called The Four Sounds. This one from January 1961 on the Tough label. Not the same Tough label, that Abner Spector label that has Sally Go Round the Roses. This label is out of Indianapolis, Indiana. It's by request for Warren, The Four Sounds, with a song called The Ring.
Something old, something new, something borrowed, something blue. Then a ring around your finger on our way. The crowd will smile as we stroll down the aisle. And a ring around your finger on our wedding day. You'll be wearing a gown. All the people will stand. Here comes the bride, the organ will play as music will fill the air. Shoes and rice, a honeymoon on that day we wed in June. Then a ring around your finger on our wedding day.
By request for Bopper Boy Warren, currently in the top shelf oldies chart. That is The Four Sounds, The four sounds from January 1961 on the Tough label. This Tough label out of Indianapolis, Indiana. Song entitled The Ring. Just noticed I am in Vinyl Treasure overtime. Hope you're digging on the tunes here for a Saturday evening. And let's continue here. Let's head out to Hollywood, California for this next song. And it's a cover, as the original was initially done by Billy and the Kids on the Loot label. Now, both of the versions of this song were out at the same time, and I'm playing the cover version, which came out on the Finer Arts label as done by Doug and Freddie and the Pyramids. Now, both versions were out at the same time, and this Doug and Freddie is really, they are really Doug Salma and Freddie Ruiz from El Monte, California, and both are cool versions of the tune, very similar in sound. And this one produced and directed by Gary Paxton. I think it's probably his label, Finer Arts Records. Let's go back to May of 1961 for Doug and Freddie and the Pyramids and their rendition of the tune, Take a Chance on Love. Cover tunes here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. I feature them every show. Yes, every show I do. Doug and Freddie and the Pyramids, May 1961. Finer Arts Records, Take a Chance on Love. I think I like Billy and the Kids a little bit better than that cover tune, but that's still a good one, too. John G here spinning original vinyl 45s. We are in Vinyl Treasure overtime. Let's go to 1962 for another Odd Amy 45, and the only release for this artist. This one arranged and directed by someone by the name of Tommy Falcone. This artist goes by the name of Joe Templeton, and this record was released in May of 1962. There's a group backing them up. They're called the Centuries. Let's give it a spin. We go back to Amy Records. This is a mint styrene promo for Joe Templeton and the Centuries from May of 62. The song is called Lover Be Fair.
When we're apart, be fair. tired of cheating like you do. Now you taunt me, you hurt me, and you say you'll desert me. Oh, why do you treat me this way?
I like that tune. That's a cool purchase for a buck. You really can't go wrong for something like that. Joe Templeton with the Centuries, May 1962 release on the Amy record label, song entitled Lover Be Fair. Always be fair with your lover. That's what Johnny G says. Let's continue. We are on Vinyl Treasure Overtime, and let's flip over a rare 45 I played a couple weeks ago on the Al Jacks label. This one, label owned by Alonzo Tucker and Clarence Jackson. The group was called the Celtics. I played the side called Can You Remember? Let's give a listen to the flip side of the 45, which is an up-tempo side from 1962. Give a listen to the Celtics. The Celtics on Al Jacks. And the flip side, I don't know if it's the A or B side, never really looked at the numbers, but it's called Send Me Someone to Love.
Send me someone to love. Send me, oh Lord above. Send me, please send me someone to love. That I need a love that's fair. Send me, please send me someone to love.
Someone to love, love that's true. Makes my life worthwhile. I know you hear my plea.
And send someone to me. Girl that gay, to be please happy, for night and day, send me, please send me someone to love.
Rare Sound of Detroit, I think, yeah, that's Detroit, right? Yes, Rare Detroit 45 here on the Vinyl Treasure Overtime. They're called the Celtics from 1962, Al Jacks Records, Send Me Someone to Love. Well, they definitely did that for your host, Johnny G. Let's continue here for 1962. We go back to New York City. Danny Robinson's Everlast record label for this one. Lots of controversy on the release date of this next 45, as some of the sites have have this as a 1958 release, which I strongly disagree with. This one is a 1962 release. I think Danny Robinson, he stopped this label for some reason. Then he resurrected it and printed out these 1960 presses. Of course, the print is different. It's bigger. They're bigger print on these 1960 presses. So it's this Everlast number 503. If someone knows different, you can send Johnny G an email. I will debate with you for sure. But anyway, the song is interesting because I don't think this word or what what this song is about is really done anymore. So you tell me the last time you heard of a couple eloping. I don't know. Does anybody elope anymore? I don't think they do. I think they just live together in sin is what they do. But anyway, this is a cool tune from 1962. It's by a group called The Extremes. The Extremes is on the Everlast label. And the name of the tune is called Let's Elope. Elope tonight. We should do that. Yes, but The Extremes. Whoops, as my needle became extremely possibly damaged there. But anyway, The Extremes from 1962 on the Everlast record label, song entitled Let's Elope. Let's continue here. We continue here for this next artist, which I really can't tell you much about, but this song did come out on two different labels that were owned by Morty Kraft. First came out on the Kraft label sometime in mid-1962, but then it was re-released for some reason on the Trans Atlas label, a label that was earlier known as Warwick. He just changed the name of the label. It kept the same numbering system. So Warwick Records changed to Trans Atlas Records, and the B-sides, I think, of the Kraft release and the Trans Atlas are different songs, but the A-sides, both the same. I'm featuring the A-side of the Trans Atlas release, and we'll play the B-side at a later date. But anyways, from 1962, it was written by the artist. His name is Donnie Marchand. Donnie Marchand, it's on the Trans Atlas label. The name of the tune is called Round in Circle.
Round in circles.
No.
Round in circles, round in circles, round in circles I did go. Round in circles, round in circles, round in circles.
still love you. The days linger on, and I can't do without you. Round in circles I do go. Oh, my darling, I must know. Tell me, where are you? I look everywhere. I've got so much to say, dear. Why can't you be fair and stop running away, dear? Please stop playing hard to get. Sailing games won't help you get all that. Your picture on the wall keeps smiling through it all. Tells me not to give up now. So here I go again. I hope for the last time I'll find you again. Maybe this is the right time. All round in circles I'd go. Oh, my darling, I must know. Tells me not to give up now. So here I go again. I hope for the last time I'll find you again. Maybe this is the right time. Around in circles I do go. Oh, my darling, I must know. Tell me.
As Donnie Marchand, 1962, that is actually the second release of the record. The Trans Atlas label goes for more money than the Kraft record. Don't ask me why. Anyways, call, song entitled Round in Circles, Flip Sides of the Nice Ballad. We'll get that one on a future Vinyl Treasure Show. This also has another release on the Mohawk label that I do have. I don't know how good that one is. Anyway, let's continue for a little bit more here on the Vinyl Treasure Show. Up next, an interracial group from Westchester County. And that is definitely my neck of the woods. And this 45 is my Aunt Mary's original record. I don't know if I've ever played one of her original 45s here on the show. And I do want to get her up here to be a guest on the Vinyl Treasure Show and talk about the records and play some of her favorite songs and records that maybe that she never had but always wanted. That would be interesting to me. But this was one of her 45s, and she got this one in one of the hundreds of boxes of 45s that she would purchase from our local a disc jockey distributor. He would distribute the records and the jukeboxes in the local establishments, the restaurants, and the bars here in the area. And his name was Seymour Pollock. And I never really got to meet him. And unfortunately, he died young. And I wanted to buy all the records is what I really wanted to do. But she would get these records, and I would put them on my... I had a General Electric Victrola. It was a plastic Victrola, you know, like the ones that you open up and had these two speakers on the side. You would pull them out like they had like this long wire that you can put one on one side and one on the other side. Actually, you got a great sound from that record player. It was the needle that you can flip, like it had a 78 on one side and a 45 on the other. So I could stack about six or seven records depending on the thickness, and they would drop down this big centerpiece. You know, you'd bring the arm over, it would clasp them on, and they would fall down. Sometimes if I put too many, it would like fall on the needle, and it would kind of get me upset. But anyway, she liked this one, and she would take a red crayon, she would make like a little mark on the side that was the side that she liked. and maybe she couldn't remember the titles, I don't know. And then what I did later on when she gave me all her records, I put little X marks on it with like black magic marker. I should shoot myself for that. And these, a lot of these records, they would have these like these gouges in the label, like something with the jukebox that they were using at the time, would like maybe the counter or whatever to show that the record was played. I don't know, but this was her record, and the group is called the Meridians, and it features Roger Bruno on lead. It's an expensive 45. It's a great two-sided record. Came out in August of 64. The Meridians on Parnasso. This is my aunt's original copy. A song called Have You Forgotten? The Meridians, Meridians on the Parnasso record label. Roger Bruno's on lead. Great two-sided 45. And she probably knew nothing about that record, but she just kept it for the sound there. But the Meridians, as John G. loses his babbling voice here, August 64, Have You Forgotten? Let's continue for a couple more here. Let's go to August of 1962 for this next artist. Really can't tell you much about him, though. It's on Johnny Vincent's Ace record label. The song was written, though, by Huey Piano Smith. The artist goes by the name of Bubba. How many people do you know named Bubba? Bubba Anderson is his name, and this is the A side of the 45, August 62, Bubba Anderson on Ace with a song called Where Has My Lover Gone?
Fortune teller.
That's Johnny Vincent's ace record label for that one, Bubba Anderson. Bubba Anderson, his name is his name, August 1962, as Jai G is getting a little giddy here. Bubba Anderson with a song entitled, Where Has My Lover Gone? Should have called it Fortune Teller. Is that what he said? I don't know. Anyway, let's go for a couple more here before Jai G signs off here. And this is another cover song here on the Vinyl Treasure Show, as this song was first done in 1961. Some of you collectors may know, on the Thunder label, by a duet, Freddie and Lou. And Freddie was really Fred Parris, who wrote the song. But this is a female version of the song, which is pretty good in my opinion. Warren's going to have to hear this one on the archive, because I think he's going to like this one. It's from April of 63. We go back to the Amy label. Her name is Pearline Caesar. Pearline Caesar. And let's give a listen to her rendition of the song, Be Mine Tonight. April 1963, cover tune there by Pearline Caesar. Pearline Caesar on the Amy record label, song entitled Be Mine Tonight. Two more 45s to go before John G signs off here. Let's continue. Go back to Detroit, Michigan. Well, the first presses of this were released in the Detroit, Michigan area, but then the label owner, he relocated to Nashville, Tennessee. Then he pressed them down there on a different color label. And I'm talking about the Landrod record label. As those presses down in Nashville were a red label, the Detroit presses were on a yellow label. And I'm featuring the yellow label Landrod out of Detroit. This one's from 1963. It's Edward Hamilton and the Arabians. It's on the Landrod record label. The name of the tune is called Now You Have to Cry Alone.
You refuse to believe in me, and I told you no lie. Every time I was a minute late, I had to apologize. nothing new. You accused me of so many things, but I know I've been true. Now,
right now,
it is over.
Over.
You have to cry. Tell me, what will you do? It's no good for a woman to be alone. This ought to be a lesson to you, hey. Now,
right now,
it is over.
Over.
You have to cry.
Devin and Motown sound there on that one for Edward Hamilton and the Arabians. 1963 release on the Landrod record label out of Detroit. I featured the side out of Detroit, Michigan, song entitled Now You Have to Cry Alone. And that's going to do it, folks. For Johnny G and the Vinyl Treasure Show, I want to thank you for joining. Johnny G, listening to original vinyl 45s out of my collection. You want to get in touch with me, send me an email at vinyltreasures@aol.com. I also have an account, JohnnyGsVinyltreasures@gmail.com. Let me know that you're digging on the tunes or anything you want to hear. I'm working on requests. Sometimes it's difficult. I was looking for that Cassius Clay 45. I have it on the pink Columbia label, but I couldn't find it. No, I couldn't. But that's going to do. We're going to close the show this evening from April of 1964 for another 45 I absolutely have no information on, although I think this record is an in-demand Northern Soul tune. I'm playing the B-side of the 45. Came out on a label called United International Label, and it was written by the lead singer. He goes by the name of Jeff Lane. And there's also another name there, a writer called Marion Lane. So that could either be his wife, his sister, or his mother. It's one of those three, but who cares? I think it's a fine tune. The closer tonight is from April 64, United International, Jeff Lane with a song called You Put a Hurt on Me. Well, I definitely can say that Johnny G had the hurt last Saturday evening when I was in the emergency room. It was just a horrible, horrible evening for me, but I am getting back in shape, and that's going to do it, folks. And I want you to tune into my buddy Dave the Raven, his Relics and Rarities show tomorrow evening starting at 9 p.m. right here on Top Shelf Oldies, 9 to midnight for my buddy Dave the Rave. That's going to do it, folks. I will be back next Saturday from 10 to midnight right here on Top Shelf Oldies. I'm recording this on the Ustream Broadcaster. We'll get it up on my YouTube account. You can also come to Ustream Broadcaster and you can watch the show live. You have to get ad blocker. Contact Charlene Whiteside if she could help you with the ad blocker. And I don't know if you get those crazy ads on Ustream. They could be annoying for sure, but I don't think you get those, at least to block out the sound on the YouTube video. And we also have my own website. Did I even post my show last week? I did not. See, I had a crazy week last week. I apologize. I will do both shows this evening. I promise I will. Well, that's going to do enough of my babbling. And I hope to see you here next Saturday evening right here on Top Shelf Oldies. Johnny G, just want to say, everybody, so long.
People are talking since we've been apart. My friends all told me
you would break my heart. But I was so cool, let you play me for a fool. You put a hurt on me, a hurt on me. When I first met you, you were so sweet and kind. But now, pretty baby, tears flowing from my eyes. But I was so cool, let you play me for a fool. You put a hurt on me, you hurt me so bad. Is talking since we've been apart. Cause I wouldn't listen when she told me, son, that girl's gonna break your heart. But I was so cool, let you play me for a fool. You put a hurt on me, a hurt on me.